let me know sort of like what was happening in this space, because it's amazing, it's beautiful. What were some of your favorite elements here?
There's a lot. I mean, first, the architecture of the space itself, it's huge. This is definitely breaking a lot of boundaries of what a suite can be on a ship. So this is pioneering some new ground just without any of this stuff, which is pretty exciting. The living space, first of all, we have two floors, which is also
amazing.
A big deal. The wall windows is really what you have to beckon with and you want to design around. I don't want anything to just hit too hard to compete with the outside.
The
complexities of the water, that's what this
the ocean.
The ocean is the star. But in doing that, I wanted to bring in kind of the opposite of all that curve and the stripes coming down on these long floor-to-ceiling curtains, bringing in some moments from, you know, we recognize from home design.
You have the eaves.
Really quickly, right. So often when we get into big hotel chains or big transportation companies, we can get to a corporate place that it looks a bit corporate, so I want to break it up with earthy home.
Absolutely.
Eames is that. Absolutely. John Robshaw.
I love the pillows.
I'm so happy that they made it onto the ship, and I think it just adds a kind of surprise and delight that you wouldn't expect.
It absolutely does. It's cozy. Like, I mean, I think you guys have all sort of crafted here what feels like a personal space. And you feel like the accessories that you added in really helped that to happen?
The accessories are key, because on a ship, everything moves. So you have to be really wary about what you can and can't use. You can't have a lot of smalls.
Yeah.
Because one shake and poof, they all come falling down. So it's how do we build that sense of home in alternative ways with some recognizable things, maybe positioned or attached in ways that we wouldn't have to do at home. It was a big learning curve for me.
I love it. I love it. I want to live here.
Oh, I kind of do too. I would love to just stay here for a night.
Just stay here for a couple nights.
Well, I could have all of you over, or you could have all of us over, because it's so enormous. The dining area is also really special when it comes to any kind of out of the house experience, hotel and beyond. You don't often have this kind of space.
It's a huge dining table.
It's huge.
Eight people.
Yes.
What about these chairs?
These are a pearlized leather, which we worked a really long time to get just right, because it's really easy to get it just wrong.
Okay.
So you have to have it stretched right. The sheen has to be in the right place. The puckers have to be the all of the tufting. It was an arduous process, all the chairs. But chairs are really the jewelry of every room.
It is.
You know?
This room has a lot of bling happening. You have this amazing chandelier, which is like glittering and beautiful. And the art behind you too, like what's happening with all this art I see.
We do have a separate art department for the most part that comes in and does the extra layer. We have conversations throughout the process, but it is its own team in itself. And I think it definitely went to more of a graphic, obviously pop art place, which I think is pretty fun for a hotel.
And it adds that layer of color.
I mean, we're not too serious here. We're in the middle of the ocean floating, and we're going to be having parties in this space. Right. It isn't traditional fireplace in Christmas time. It's party time. And I think they really conveyed that with those pieces. And then we walk into the media room. I think hardwood floors to Janine were just a big push for me as well. We can't use real wood on any ship, even cutting boards.
Oh, wow.
Because of fire code. There are so many safety codes that you have to use different mediums and make up or invent.
Things you don't think about.
New medium.
That's different for the ship environment.
Right.
No wood.
Or the weight of everything. You don't see big stone floors because it's too heavy.
Absolutely.
We're floating.
This media room is so beautiful.
My favorite.
And you have some really fun stuff going on in here.
I talked
about earlier.
Yes.
With, you know, the photography and some elements you created yourself.
This is a piece that I did pick and I feel like it really makes the entire space. I think it could be one of my favorite things on the entire ship. And it's from a dear friend, a wonderful photographer named Genevieve Gorder. And again, it's bringing in some of the earthiness of land just to balance off floating in the middle of the ocean.
Absolutely.
I don't need to recreate the woods, but to have stone textures, to have wood textures, to have really earthy imagery, I think is integral.
And it's really also that personalized feel. Again, this is someone that you know that you're close to and being able to bring this.
And it's
in.
Here? It's awesome. This is probably the craziest thing that I got on the ship. It's like a Jen sprinkle in the suites.
You need your sprinkles. And I love it.
I'm hoping to coat, but this is the sprinkle. This was in Germany. I was touring all of this while it was being built, just raw steel, which was awesome. Wow. And if you're nerdy like we are in design, you just like, it's Tinker Toys and you're so excited. But I saw this hanging on the side of a wall. It's actually the HVAC plans for, I think, this deck of the ship. And it look how intricate. So I'd never seen anything so complex in home planning. Yeah. And I, what is this? And they told me, I said, we have to make this into a wallpaper or a textile.
I love it.
And they did it. It was like, okay, done.
Yeah.
And it ended up being on the ship. I haven't seen the ship for almost 10 months now, so it's nice.
It's beautiful. And I have to say that this actually appeals to me too. I don't think I've ever told you, but my father-in-law is a draftsman.
No.
And did iron work. So these are the kinds of pieces he has sitting at home that I'm like, that'd be perfect for wallpaper. So it's so cool that you did that.
Well,
you made it happen.
Patterns and plans are sometimes the most boring stage for people when it comes to aesthetics. But if you take a look at it a little closer, it's sometimes the most beautiful.
It is, and you keep it like it's tied into the room. It's that graphic black
and
white.
Soul. That's soul. That's
it.
Soul. You know,
those
that's
are the
what
soul pieces.
You need soul when it comes to hospitality, you know? Because no one person is staying there for too long.
All right, we're going to go up to the bedroom.
Upstairs. Obviously, this is the sleeping quarters. And what I wanted in this space was the ability to close it off and blackout curtain this area so you could actually have this open all day and not have to go down and close it. It's
absolutely
a perch.
Absolutely. It's beautiful. It's a little nest.
It's a nest.
That's happening up here.
Well, and having just a couple of classic, elegant black chairs and a little perch to view the view, I think is integral and will be used. I think it's about, if there was a key word that I kept in my mind besides being earthy, it was elegance. This is such an incredible way to travel and in transportation in general in our country. We've lost a lot of the glamour.
Sort of luxury.
As it becomes mass, which is wonderful that we can all do it, but it's lost the style.
Like
we were styling.
You want to get to that glamour and sort of the Hollywood glam element that's actually happening in this space.
Tailored. Elegance.
Yeah.
So I'm just trying to get it in, and we'll get it rolling.
And I like how you were talking about the sea itself as an element in the space. It's like
you ignore
the
that.
Best artistic piece that you could have is the natural water outside.
You gotta pull back, because that's the star.
Fantastic, I love it.
Have you been in the bathroom?
No, I haven't.
Well, let's go in. I think storage is a real luxury when it comes to hotel and being away from home. If you have storage, you kind of feel like you made it.
It's like a Sex in the City walk-in
this
closet.
This is like Kim Kardashian's closet.
Karen Bradshaw.
Yeah! But you know what I've learned living in Manhattan? That these super narrow and sometimes strangely shaped spaces are really great lessons for urban living as well.
Absolutely.
How do we store? How do we space plan? Because no one would think traditionally to do two vanities and the bath in the middle.
No, you wouldn't think it. You don't think it could happen.
Does it feel crowded at all?
Absolutely not. The materials that are used in here are absolutely amazing. And it doesn't feel crowded. It's beautiful. And then you guys have, again, there's this
art
that's
happening.
This
is one of my favorite. This one I chose too, and I'm really happy that it made it through. It's like these 100 little eggshells, and they're all the lofts and suites in gold, all mixed metals.
And they've just been painted silver and
metallic on the inside and matte on the outside. They're so cute.
Beautiful. And another sort of calming element that's in this space as well.
Well, art in general in hotel and hospitality, we all have been like, hotel art.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So any chance you get to make it not hotel art is a good opportunity.
Different and distinctive.
Yeah. And then, probably don't want to shoot this
part. We can live in here.
But this is pretty hot. There's another jacuzzi on the deck. And can you imagine let's just imagine showering
so
in here.
Beautiful.
And you're looking out at the ocean, you hop into your jacuzzi, you can just be naked all day. What's better than that?
Running in and out.
Yes.
And this piece is great too.
I think someone's hanging
Okay, we're gonna hang that
That's
up.
Not hung up yet. It's November.
This is fantastic, Jen. What you've done is great. I love all your little sprinkles. And it's just
Jen
like
sprinkles.
Perfect luxury, you know, place to enjoy.
It's nice to be at the party.
Yeah. Thanks for inviting us.
Anytime. Thanks for the interview.